why to allow God the chance to create the first few living beings? You remove God from the scene. Like you must have read God Delusion. You know, God Delusion, written by Dawkins, is another Dawkins. That Dawkins, old Dawkins, is new Dawkins. So this Dawkins wrote a book, God Delusion, and in London they put in many of the buses, God probably is not there, enjoy life. That's what they put up in London, many of the buses. So after Dawkins wrote that book, another fellow wrote, you know, Dawkins Delusion, another fellow wrote the book. But the point is what? There is a very strong spirit of atheism which works very hard to brush God aside and to come up with some kind of theory of how the living forms must have originated on their own. And when they made that theory, you saw how much of a defeat it faces even by the other scientists. This is not opposed by religionists. Religionists may not know so much. But the other scientists have studied them very carefully and they have presented their objections in a very systematic fashion. So one thing I covered till now is spontaneous generation of living forms from matter. So now another thing regarding this mutation this is the one. Yeah, see here, you heard about the Cambrian explosion. You heard about this. The Cambrian explosion, what it says here, you see, during the Cambrian period, an abundance of complex multicellular life appeared suddenly within as brief a period as 5 to 10 million years, which is a blink of an eye, geologically speaking. These forms seem to appear out of nowhere. As per evolution theory, simple forms were present earlier, which were transformed into more and more complex forms later. So we could expect that early fossils show only simple forms, older fossils show more forms. But here in Cambrian explosion, multiple forms which had highly complex structures, they came out all of a sudden. So you ask any evolutionist, he will say, sorry sir, please don't bring this one thing, they will tell you. This is one thing they cannot answer. They know it, but they have no answer for it. And another thing, you will see that see here the Bohr letters, I'll just make it little bigger. See the fossil evidence, you all know, for example, the fossil evidence, how it is expected according to Darwin's evolution. Now we are finished with the life coming from matter thing, that's over. Now we are talking about evolution, one form into another form. Here if you see, for example, you say the fish is getting, according to Darwin, the fish was in water, then it came out as an amphibian, say like a frog, then it became a snake, then afterwards it is supposed to grow wings and become a bird, isn't it? Then it becomes a bird and it's supposed to fly. This is the way it's supposed to evolve, isn't it? So take a fish for example, fish has got the fins, they should become hands and legs, isn't it? Fish has got the gills for respiration, naturally that should turn into heart, is it not true? So that is the point made here. For instance, there should be fish fins changing into amphibian legs with feet and toes and gills changing into lungs, isn't it? There should be reptiles with front limbs changing into bird wings, correct, no? In case reptiles have to change into birds. Similarly, the back limb changing into legs with the claws. But there are no such links found between these things. It is only a postulate till date. You can ask. There are hundreds of evidences by different scientists to show. I wanted to show one thing. Just one minute. You have the sound card, yeah? Where is the sound card? This is a short clip, 2 minutes clip, you can see that. It's connected.
Evolutionists go so far in this subject that they can even invent very different faces for the same skull. The three entirely different reconstructions made for the fossil calls in Xanthropus is a famous example showing how persistent evolutionists are in producing these false masks. Another intermediate transitional form fabricated by evolutionists was the Nebraska Man. This was cooked up in 1922 on the basis of a single fossil tooth. The evolutionists did not neglect to give it an ostentatious Latin name, Hesperopithecus Harold-Cooka, or to make imaginary drawings related to it. It was soon revealed that the tooth that had been the source of inspiration for Nebraska Man, in fact, belonged to a wild pig.
So these were some of the evidences. Now coming back to our... this mic is working? Yeah. So... see, below you will see... Darwin also expected that actually the species would go from unicellular to multicellular and all. But they found actually that the multicellular things and unicellular coexisted in many places. See here, for example, the wrong fossil order sequence. What is the wrong fossil order sequence? Sometimes more developed creatures are earlier than they are underground, much below than they have found out like that also. Similarly, the record of the rocks, these are the things which he was speaking, Ajay was speaking about the, you know, he was giving a list of the hominids, you know, you can make it a little bigger. See, according to the record of the rocks, hominids are man-like creatures, you know, began to evolve from ape-like ancestors in Africa about 4 million years ago, correct, no? And then they said 4 to 2 million years ago, Australopithecines. And then after that, you know, then 1.5 million years ago. So now there are evidences to show that very developed man existed even 5 million years ago also. Because according to them, the human beings started evolving from 4 million only. But now you may wonder, if you are saying, what to 5, even 10 million years ago also there are evidences that of human beings having existed. Now why those evidences were not brought, we may have a question. In fact, we have a book called as Forbidden Archaeology, which is a written by Michael Cremo, a very famous book. So in that book, he wrote that book. He went to all the universities and requested them to get permission for opening their opening their godown and everything and study all the different skulls. So the skulls which were not matching with Darwin, according to Darwin, you are only supposed to get human forms coming from 4 million years ago also, they are not very developed forms, as you rightly said, according to him. But whenever they got evidence which showed 5 million years ago, 10 million years ago, humans existed, what they did, they kept it inside the, you know, godown. They thought this is not matching with Darwin. But now, Forbidden Archaeology book, all those evidences are brought out. He has published them. In America, when this Forbidden Archaeology book was published and videos were shown, they said this is one thing which evolutionists don't like to see, because it goes deadly against the evolution theory. It's not that humans, as the record of the rocks show, you will see that actually monkeys existed, apes existed, and parallelly humans have existed in a very developed form also. We will come to that point separately. I want to say one thing about breeding. Actually, breeding is not evolution. Like you will see, for example, one scientist says here, seen as a natural mutation, which means actually, I'll just show you. Sometimes you can externally, man-made, you were saying about that point. Who said that point? Man-made and... see, the accidental changes in the nucleus of the cell, that is actually called mutation. So how do they originate? If you see, in the growth of self-production when it happens, there may be some problems with which it happens. You know what is the result of that? For example, the flies having little longer wings may get little shorter wings, or they may get some broken wings. Or sometimes the moth's color, for example, if it was bright brown, it becomes light brown or something like that. But beyond that, it doesn't make any change in the species in itself. It doesn't make. For example, you can cause external mutation also by using radiation and chemicals. You can do that. Cause external mutation. If you do that, that is more of an accident, as it is mentioned. Accidents cause harm, not good, he says. See, 2000 experiments were conducted on fruit flies. You will see here, see the scientists are saying here. See what the scientific American is saying here. It says, living beings are enormously diverse in form, but the form is remarkably constant within any given line of descent. Pigs remain pigs, oak trees remain oak trees, generation after generation. New species don't come. See, for example, here, these flies, these are fruit flies. 2000 experiments were conducted on them. By any